Hi all, welcome to OET Speaking. Today we can discuss an OET role play. Here the setting is an emergency department. You are speaking to the mother of a 6-year-old boy who was brought to hospital because of accidental ingestion of a button. You have checked his vital signs which are within normal limits. Task: greet the parent, ask what happened and find out the size of button. Ask the parent what she did to retrieve the button. Find out if the child shown any abnormal signs, trouble breathing, crying, inability to swallow, loss of consciousness. Reassure the parent that the child's breathing appears normal. Explain what normally happens in such cases. Small objects are generally eliminated naturally through defecation. Reassure the parent. The doctor will see the child very soon. Explain what the doctor may do. X-ray scan to ascertain the position. If the object is stuck, it can be removed with an endoscope and a sedation. From this background information, we understand that a nurse is talking to a parent and the child swallowed a button. Here we already checked the vital signs of that child, which is normal limits. As per the task, we need to talk with the parent and collect history about foreign body ingestion, reassure the mother and explain what we are going to do next. Here, this setting is an emergency department and we check the child's vital signs which is stable. So, you have the details of child with you. In this situation, we can start our conversation by wishing the parent according to the time. Here you can wish good morning or good afternoon. Then you can introduce yourself. My name is Sarah. I am a registered nurse working in this emergency department. Then you can say, I know that you brought your son here because he swallowed a button. Is that right? Probably the parent may tell you, sister, I am really worried because my child is only 6 years. He swallowed a button. Could you please do something or we need to reassure the parent. We can say, I understand you are really concerned about your child's condition. Try not to be worried. There is nothing to be worried. Just now I checked his vitals parameters, which is in normal range. In this way you can reassure the parent. After that you can ask the name of parent and child. So you can ask like, for my confirmation, may I know your name and your son's name? Then the parent will tell her name and son's name. Let's assume the name of mother is Mrs. Maria and the child is Aiden. Here, as per our first task, we need to greet the parent, ask what happened and size of button. Here we already greeted the parent. Then we can collect the more history. So we can ask like, could you please tell me what exactly happened? And probably the mother may tell you, like, my son swallowed a button. He swallowed it while he was playing and I was near to him. All of a sudden, he went near to the chair and picked up something and swallowed. But I know it's a button. I couldn't pick that. Then we can ask the size of button. You can ask like, could you please tell me how big it is? Then probably the mother may tell you, actually it is not very big, it's something like 1 or 2 centimeter. Then as per our second task, we can ask like, if I heard you correct, the size of button is about 1 or 2 centimeter, is that right? Then probably the mother may reply like, I am not sure, but it is almost 2 centimeter. Then as per the second task, we can ask nurse question like, would you mind telling me what you did to retrieve the button? Or you can ask question like, did you do something to take it out? Then probably as per the interlocutor's card, she may tell you like, I pressed the chest and abdomen area and made him cough, but nothing happened. So I'm really concerned. That's why I brought him here. Then we can tell her like, yes, Mrs. Maria, you did the right thing. You are at the right place. We are here to help your child. And as per our third task, we can ask question like, have you noticed any kind of labored breathing or loss of consciousness? Probably the mother may tell you like, actually I couldn't see any abnormalities, but still I'm worried whether it block in Z or not. But sister, he is only 6 years old child, so I really concerned. In this situation, we need to reassure the mother and as per our fourth task. Then we can say like, Mrs. Maria, I understand your feelings. You are really concerned that he might have some choking. Since he has not shown any abnormal signs till now, like coughing, breathing difficulties, loss of consciousness. So, in this case, you don't need to be worried. Now, his breathing appears normal and his vital parameters also within normal range. So, there is nothing to be concerned about. He is fine. There is no obstruction. If there is any obstruction, he would have trouble breathing. So, please relax now. Then, as per our fifth task, we need to explain what will happen now. So, you can tell like, Mrs. Maria, being a mother, I understand your situation. I will explain what normally happens in such situation. Usually, these small objects like this button gets illuminated naturally through defecation, but in order to ensure that it has gone inside, we will do an X-ray or scan to ascertain the position of button. As your child is breathing properly, it's a good sign he will be able to pass button when he opens the bowel next time. Mrs. Maria, I assure you that he will be able to pass the button when he opens the bowel next time. Are you following me? Then you can tell her like the doctor will come soon and see your child. Probably the parent may ask you how long it will take. Then we can reply like, it will take approximately 2 to 3 minutes. Sometimes the parent may ask you a question like, if it's stuck inside or on somewhere, what will do? At that time, as per our task, we can reply like, Miss Maria, I do really understand your anxiety. There is nothing to be alarmed about because your son is breathing properly. If it's stuck inside, it can be removed with a special type of instrument which is called an endoscope. It will be under anesthesia and it's not a painful procedure. You don't have to worry about that. Then probably the mother may tell you like, he's only 6 years, is it okay to give sedation? Then we can reply like, Mrs. Maria, there is a range of medication that we can give to children. So you don't have to worry. You know, Mrs. Maria, we have managed several cases like this and it's a quite common occurrence in children and the complications are very rare. Now our task finished, so we can wind up by saying, do you have any other concerns? If there is no concerns, we can say, thank you for listening to me. If you need any more help, please press the buzzer. Then you can say, the doctor will come and check your child soon after I leave. Thank you, Mrs. Maria. Once again, I assure you, there is nothing to be alarmed. Or there is nothing to be worried. He is safe in our hands. In this way, you can end up your role play. Thank you.